Hello students, in today's video lecture we will start our new book, that is Vistas. Okay, and today we will discuss the chapter, that is the first chapter, titled as the third level. Okay student, the third level is symbolic of escape route from day to day anxieties, stress, tension, uncertainties and insecurities of the modern world. It is the imaginary world of deceit and fantasies which remain unrealized in one's life. Okay, it is the imaginary culmination of one's end of ordeals and stark realities of an attainment of mental peace. Students, if we talk about this chapter, the third level, it has been written by Jack Finney. Okay, and before reading this chapter line by line or giving you the explanation of it, I want you to tell something about its introduction. Okay. Dear students, the third level by Jack Finney is about the harsh realities of war. Okay, war has irreversible consequences, results that leaving people in a state of insecurity. Students, you know, war kills the final feeling of love and sympathy among human beings. Okay, and it raises the state of insecurity in them. It is also about modern day problems and how common man tends to escape reality by various means. In this story, a man named Charlie hallucinates he has some illusions and he reaches the third level of the Grand Central Station, which only has two levels. Means to escape from his anxiety, stress and hallucination, the narrator, okay, Charlie, he reaches to the next level of Grand Central Rail Station. Okay, according to him, there are three level of Grand Central Station, but in reality there were only two levels. Okay, so it is a journey, time journey to a different level, just to escape from the insecurity and the feeling of stress and strain. Okay students, let me tell you something about its theme, and thereafter we'll go through or we'll have a line by line explanation of this chapter. Okay, the third level is a story that weaves together a psychological journey of the narrator into past, present and moves towards future. There is always a natural human tendency to constantly move between the past, the present and the future. Students, living our life, we sometimes feel ourselves, we sometimes try to recall the past events. Okay, living in present, we sometimes try to move to past, and even we sometimes imagine for the future also. Past, present and future are strategically and organically interconnected. Okay, they are in a planned way, they are quite interconnected, past, present and future. Okay, man is mortal. Okay, clear, he has to die one day and has many good and bad aspects of life, like love, profit, loss, good, bad, etc. All these aspects tend to affect the human mind. Okay, the existential worries act like a catalyst for making the human mind constantly move between the past, the present and the future. Okay. The third level is a study of human mind caught in this cycle of time. Okay, clear? So if we talk about, it is a journey of from present to past and past to future. Okay, so third level is a study of human mind caught in this cycle of time. Okay, I think you have got a bit of idea of this chapter. Okay, students. Let us have a line by line explanation of this chapter, the third level, written by Jack Finney. Before, let me ask a question. Have you ever had any curious experience which others find hard to believe? If yes, please explain it to me. Okay, students, there are some moments in our life when we sometime have curious experience and others find it quite unbelievable. Okay, they don't even find it worth believing. Okay, and we have to explain them each and everything, but it depends on their interpretation, how they interpret them and how they take them for. Okay, let's read. The presidents of the New York Central and the New York, New Haven and Hartford Railroads will swear on a stack of timetables that there are only two. Okay, students, the chapter begins with a statement that the president of the New York Central, okay, New York Central Station or the and the New York and New Haven, all these and the Hartford Railroads, all these are the name of railroads and stations. They all could have severe, they will all swear on the stack of timetable. They all have a stack of timetable. You know what stack means? Stack means dher. Okay, clear? Or you can say a large, a list. Here it is mean, it means a list in which the next item to be removed is the item most recently stored. Okay, so students, these stations can easily, they easily proclaim that there are only two. There are only two levels at Grand Central Station. Okay, केवल दो हैं वहाँ पे. But I say there are three because I have been on the third level of Grand Central Station. And according to the narrator, he could easily proclaim. He could easily announce that there were three levels of Grand Central Station. Okay, उसके according ग्रैंड सेंट्रल स्टेशन के तीन लेवल हैं. यस, आई हैव टेकन द ऑब्वियस स्टेप. आई टॉक्ड टू अ साइकेट्रिस्ट फ्रेंड ऑफ माइंड. ओके, अमंग अदर्स आई टोल्ड हिम अबाउट द थर्ड लेवल एट ग्रैंड सेंट्रल स्टेशन एंड ही सेड इट वॉज अ वॉकिंग ड्रीम विथ फुलफिलमेंट. एंड वैन ही एक्सप्लेन्ड हिज स्ट्रेंज एक्सपीरियंस दैट ही हैड बीन टू द थर्ड लेवल ऑफ ग्रैंड सेंट्रल स्टेशन, his psychiatrist friend, उसका जो मनोवैज्ञानिक जो friend था ना, he told that it was just a walking dream wish fulfillment, कि it was just like a hallucination, an illusion of his. Okay, and he must have tried to fulfill his desire to escape from the world's anxiety and stress. So clear, that's why he witnessed the third level. उसको लगा कि भाई ये walking dream wish fulfillment है, that's why उसको लगता है कि Grand Central Station had three levels. He said I was unhappy, that made my wife kind of mad, but he explained that he meant the modern world is full of insecurity, fear, war, worry and the rest of it, and I just want to escape. Okay, when he told each and everything about the third level of Grand Central Station, okay, his wife even gone mad, not literally, she gone barmy, and she even kept him pursuing that there are only two levels. Okay, then his psychiatrist friend explained that that the modern world is full of insecurity, fear, war, worry, okay? And as a result, he just wanted to have escape from that. Well, who doesn't or kaun nahi chahta? Everybody I know wants to escape, but I don't want to wander down in any third level at Grand Central Station. His psychiatrist friend, iska jo Jack Finney ka jo psychiatrist friend hai na, he told him, Jack Finney ka nahin, of the narrator. The narrator's friend told him that everybody in the world wants to escape from all kind of worries, tension, stress and insecurity. Okay, and but he even himself did not want to escape from the realities and did not want to visit such a place that never exists. जो कभी एग्जिस्ट करता नहीं है इस जगह पर वो जाना भी नहीं चाहेगा. दैट इज़ द थर्ड लेवल ऑफ द ग्रैंड सेंट्रल स्टेशन. ओके बट दैट्स द रीज़न ही सेड एंड माई फ्रेंड ऑल अग्रीड एवरी थिंग पॉइंट्स टू इट. दे क्लेम्ड माई स्टैम्प कलेक्टिंग फॉर एग्जाम्पल दैट इज़ अ टेम्प्ररी रिफ्यूज फ्रॉम रियलिटी. वेल मे बी बट माई ग्रैंड फादर ग्रैंड बट माई ग्रैंड फादर डिड नॉट did not need any refuge from reality. Things were pretty nice and peaceful in his days. Okay, and from all I hear, and he started my collection. Then he exemplify his statement. His psychiatrist friends told him that, for example, his habit of collecting stamps, tickets, postal tickets, gives him. Gave him a temporary refuge, temporary shelter, and temporary excuse, escape from the world, from the modern world and its insecurity and worries and tension. Thoda sa usko raat milti when he collects stamp, okay. But he then told him that his grandfather did not need any kind of refuge or any kind of escape from reality. Okay, things then in his time were quite peaceful and pretty. Okay, and even all I hear, he started my collection, and it was his grandfather who started collecting stamps for him. It's a nice collection too, blocks of four of practically every US issue, first day covers and so on. Then he told what his grandfather's collection carry. Okay, his grandfather's collection contained US issues, okay, United States issues, the first day cover, a kind of you can say when a new stamp is issued for the first time, okay, it is bought and it is pasted on an envelope, okay, that is sent that the bearer sent to his own address. That is called first day cover. Later you will be explained it well. And even he laid stress on the fact that the President Roosevelt, Franklin D. Roosevelt, he also collected stamps. Okay, so it's a common habit of people to have escape from reality. Okay, students, you know why we Can you answer why we adopt a particular hobby? The simplest answer will be that we have hobbies just to make our time pass, just to have a good pastime, okay, or just to escape from the kind of tensions we are having due to the as a result of modern life and its insecurity. Okay, so yahi hoti hai, you know. You all have some hobbies. Someone likes to sing. Okay, singing is their hobby. Okay, so they sing whenever they are troubled. Whenever they feel troubled and exhausted. Okay, they try to sing and try to get relax. Okay, clear? Anyway, here is what happened at Grand Central Station. One night last summer, I worked late at the office. I was in a hurry to get uptown to to my apartment. So I decided to take the subway from Grand Central because it's faster than the bus. Okay. Then now the narrator is telling how it happened when he reached his imaginary world, so-called imaginary world, or so-called his real world, that is the third level at the Grand Central Station. He said one night in last summer, he worked late at the office mein late tak kaam kiya, and he was in a hurry to get uptown to get to his apartment, to his building. Okay, so he decided to take the subway, the underground way from Grand Central Station, because it was faster than the bus. Okay, clear? So he took the subway. Now I don't know why this should have happened to me. I'm just an ordinary guy named Charlie, 31 years old, and I was wearing a tan gabardine suit and a straw hat with a fancy band. I passed a dozen men who looked just like me, and I wasn't trying to escape from anything. I just wanted to get home to Louisa, my wife. Okay. Then he told his friend that he did not know why all this thing should happen to him. Okay. Clear? He told that he was just a simple man of named Charlie, who is 31 years old, 31 saal ka hai, and he was wearing, when he took the subway, okay, he was wearing tan means of brownish color here, the browning of the skin resulting exposure of the sun. Okay, clear? So here he was wearing a tan गार्बेडाइन, उसने एक टेन गार्बेडाइन पहन रखा था. यू नो गैबरडाइन क्या होता है? गैबरडाइन मीन्स होता है ट्राउजर मेड ऑफ फैनल ऑफ गैबरडाइन और ट्वीड और वाइट क्लॉथ. ओके, ऊन का जो उनके बोनों से जो बना हुआ जो सूती और रेशमी कपड़ा होता है ना, रेनकोट या बरसाती कोट का कपड़ा होता है, उससे बना हुआ कोट सूट उसने पहन रखा था. So he was wearing a brownish coat suit, okay, and a straw hat, and with a fancy band. It has a fancy band. When he was going to the Grand Central Station through the subway, he looked dozen of people just like him. Okay. And then he realized that he was not trying to escape from anything. He was just wanted to get home to his wife, Louisa. घर जाना चाहता था, कुछ भी नहीं. Okay. I turned to Grand Central from Vanderbilt Avenue. Vanderbilt Avenue से Grand Central की तरफ वो मुड़ा. Went down the steps to the first level where you take trains from 20th century. Okay. And thereafter he turned himself to the first step, first level of Grand Central Station, where they could get a 20th century train. Then I walked down another flight to the second level, okay, where suburban train leave from ducked into the an arched and old doorway heading for the subway and got lost. And then after the first level, he went towards the second level where one could get suburban trains. Okay, suburban trains mean trains that lead its passengers to the outskirt area of the town. Okay, bahar le jane ke liye wahan se train milti. And thereafter he heading for the subway pe chalta raha, and then he got lost. Phir wo kho gaya. Okay. That's easy to do. I have been in and out of Grand Central hundreds of times, but I'm always bumping into new doorways and stairs and corridors. Okay, students, it was not the first time when he was going through the tunnel and through the and he was going to Grand Central Station. Pehli baar nahi tha, but he was इन द हैबिट ऑफ गेटिंग लॉस्ट, कई बार खो जाता था बिकॉज मैनी ऑफ टाइम हंड्रेड्स ऑफ टाइम ही फाउंड सम न्यू डोरवेज एंड स्टेयर्स एंड कॉरिडोर्स, अलग अलग डोरवेज और स्टेयर्स के और कॉरिडोर उसको दिखाई देते थे. वंस आई गॉट इन टू अ टनल अबाउट अ माइल लॉन्ग एंड केम आउट इन द लॉबी ऑफ रूजवेल्ट होटल. ओके, एक बार तो क्या हुआ, ही वेंट थ्रू अ टनल, एक सुरंग में से निकला एंड एक माइल तक चलता रहा एंड देर आफ्टर ही वेंट ही केम आउट इन द लॉबी ऑफ रूजवेल्ट होटल के पास वो निकला. अनदर टाइम, दूसरे टाइम आई केम अप इन एन ऑफिस बिल्डिंग ऑन 46th Street 3 blocks अवे एंड नेक्स्ट टाइम ही केम आउट नियर अ बिल्डिंग ऑन 46th Street 46th Street में थी 3 blocks अवे, यहाँ से 3 blocks अवे इतनी दूर जाके निकला था दूसरी बार. समटाइम आई थिंक ग्रैंड सेंट्रल इज ग्रोइंग लाइक अ ट्री पुशिंग आउट न्यू कॉरिडोर्स एंड स्टेयरकेस लाइक रूट एंड समटाइम ही फील्स दैट ग्रैंड सेंट्रल स्टेशन इज ग्रोइंग लाइक अ ट्री. ओके, एवरी टाइम वेन एवर ही वेंट थ्रू द टनल ही फाउंड न्यू कॉरिडोर्स स्टेयरकेस एज इफ वन कैन फाइंड डिफरेंट रूट्स एंड इन डिफरेंट डायरेक्शन ऑफ अ ट्री. ओके, सो ही फेल्ट लाइक दिस वन, लाइक दिस यू कैन सी इन दिस फोटो. ओके, इन दिस इमेज हियर हियर द वन गेट इज गिवन हियर, अनदर इज दिस वन. ओके, क्लियर. सो दीज आर एवरी टाइम वेन एवर ही गो डाउन स्टेयर्स ही फाउंड न्यू कॉरिडोर्स एंड न्यू स्टेयर केस, इट वॉज हिज प्रॉब्लम. ओके बेटा, सो लेट्स कंटिन्यू द रीडिंग. ओके, यस, देयर प्रोबेबली अ लॉन्ग टनल दैट नोबडी नोज अबाउट फीलिंग इट्स वे अंडर द सिटी राइट नाउ ऑन इट्स वे टू टाइम स्क्वेयर एंड मे बी अनदर टू सेंट्रल पार्क. ओके, कई बार तो ऐसा लगता है कि जो टनल है ना, ही फेल्ट दैट द टनल दैट नोबडी नोज नो वन एल्स न्यू अबाउट द फीलिंग ऑफ द अंडर वे दैट राइट दैट ही वॉज फीलिंग देन. ओके, ऑन इट्स वे टू टाइम स्क्वेयर एंड मे बी अनदर टू सेंट्रल पार्क ही थॉट दैट देर आर सम टनल्स दैट लीड्स टू टाइम स्क्वेयर एंड अनदर वुड लीड टू द सेंट्रल पार्क. ओके, एंड मे बी बिकॉज सो मैनी थ्रू द ईयर्स ग्रैंड सेंट्रल हैज बीन एंड एग्जिस्ट अ वे ऑफ एस्केप एंड इफ यू टॉक अबाउट इन अदर टर्म्स ही द नरेटर टोल्ड अस दैट ग्रैंड सेंट्रल हैज एन एग्जिस्ट, इट वॉज एन इट इज काइंड ऑफ एग्जिस्ट. ओके, अ वे ऑफ एस्केप वेयर यू कैन एस्केप फ्रॉम द वर्ल्ड इनसिक्योरिटी. मे बी दैट हाउ द टनल आई गॉट इन टू, शायद हो सकता है जैसे टनल में मैं घुसा हूँ एंड बट आई नेवर टोल्ड माई साइकेट्रिस्ट फ्रेंड अबाउट दैट आइडिया बट ही कैप्ट इट अ सीक्रेट दैट ही नेवर टोल्ड हिज साइकेट्रिस्ट फ्रेंड अबाउट दिस एक्सपीरियंस दैट ही हैड गॉन थ्रू सो मैनी टनल्स एट द ग्रैंड सेंट्रल स्टेशन. ओके, क्लियर. द कॉरिडोर आई वॉज इन बिगेन एंगलिंग लेफ्ट एंड स्लैंटिंग डाउन एंड आई थॉट एंड आई थॉट आई वॉज दैट आई वॉज रॉन्ग. ओके, सो द टनल द कॉरिडोर ही बिगेन एंगलिंग लेफ्ट मीन्स वेन एवर ही टुक अ लेफ्ट टर्न. ओके, स्लैंटिंग डाउन गोइंग डाउन डाउनवर्ड. ओके, ही थॉट ही थॉट स्ट्रक इन हिज माइंड दैट ही वॉज इन द रोंग वे बट आई केप्ट ऑन वॉकिंग, लेकिन चलता रहा. ऑल आई कुड हियर वॉज द एम्प्टी साउंड ऑफ माई ओन फुट स्टेप्स एंड आई डिड नॉट पास अ सोल. When he kept going through that particular tunnel, he found no one else there in this passage. Then I heard that sort of hollow roar ahead that means open space and people talking. Thereafter, he heard some of the commotion or some of the hustle and bustle. Okay, and he guessed there might be some people near in an open space. The tunnel turned sharp left, I went down a short flight of stairs and came out on the third level at Grand Station Central Station. Thereafter, when he took left stairs, when he went downstairs, he found himself on the third level at Grand Central Station. For a moment, I thought I was back on the second level, but I saw the room was smaller. There was fewer tickets window and train gates, and the information booth in the center was wood and old looking. Okay. At first, he thought he was at the second level of on the second level of the Grand Central Station. But when he contemplated the scene, he found that the ticket counter, okay, ticket booth was in the middle of the platform. Okay, and there were small the doors were smaller, chote the, smaller than the second level and first level. Okay. Clear. And the center, the booth was made of wood, lakdi ka bana hua tha, and it was looking old, purana dikh raha tha. Okay. And the men in the booth wore a green eye shade and large black sleeve protectors. Okay. And when he looked at the man who was sitting inside the booth, he found he had put on a green eye shade usne pehen rakhi thi. Okay. Clear. And a long black sleeve, एक बड़ा काले रंग का black sleeve protectors उन्हें पहन रखे थे. Okay. Clear. And the lights were dim, sort of flickering, or there was not a bright one. It was having a dim light. Okay. And it was something flickering. Light was flickering. Okay. Flickering means टिमटिमाना होता है वैसे तो. But let's see. अस्थिर. Okay. Clear. Clear. Shining unsteadily, okay, lambent, okay, metric, uncertain, okay, clear. So then I saw why they were open flame gas lights, and then when he watched them again, he observed that these were not the bulb lights. It was these were the ओपन फ्लेम गैस लाइट, खुली फ्लेम की गैस लाइट जल रही थी, दैट्स वाई दे वर फ्लिकरिंग. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, एंड दिस विल बी द लास्ट पैरा फॉर टुडेज वीडियो. देयर वर ब्रास स्पिटून्स. स्पिटून्स क्या होते हैं? थूकदान, पीकदान होते हैं, वेयर वी स्पिट. ओके. ओके. Clear. As you can see in the image, okay. Clear. Spittons. Okay. A metal of earthware or earthware, or typically having a funnel shaped top. Okay. Clear. Used for spitting into. Thookne ke liye use kiya jata hai isko. Okay. So there were brass spittons. Kuch pital ke bane hue spittons the on the floor. And across the station, a glint of light caught my eyes. And across the station, he could a glint of light, a ray of light. Okay, chamak jo thi light ki, clear. Glint of light. It attracted his eye. It means it attracted his attention. A man was pulling a gold watch from his vest pocket. Apni vest pocket se he was pulling a watch. Okay, it was a pocket watch. He snapped open the cover, glanced at his watch and frowned. Then he, he opened his watch, gold watch. उसने खोली, उसको खोल के he watched the time, and then he put it back in and he frowned. Okay, he wore a derby hat. You know what derby means? Derby a kind of घुड़दौड़ होती है, but okay, clear. So it was a kind of derby hat usne pehen rakhi thi. Okay. A black four button suit with tiny lapels. Kuch tiny lapels ke sath usne char button ka suit pehen rakha tha. He had a big black handle bar moustache, aur uski badi badi handle bar moustache thi. Okay. Handle bar moustache thi. Okay. Uske niche handle bar jaisi thi. Okay, steering bar jaisi hoti hai waisi. Okay. क्लियर। देन आई लुक्ड अराउंड एंड सो दैट एवरी वन इन द स्टेशन वॉज ड्रेस्ड लाइक 1890 समटाइम समथिंग। देन वेन ही विटनेस्ड एंड ऑब्जर्व द ड्रेसिंग सेंस ऑफ ऑल द पीपल एट द स्टेशन ही फाउंड दैट दे वर ऑल वियरिंग समथिंग ओल्ड फैशन दैट इज ऑफ 1890 सेंचुरी क्लॉथ थे वो। ठीक है। आई नेवर सॉ सो मैनी बियर्ड्स साइड बर्न्स एंड फैंसी मूस्टेस इन माई लाइफ। ओके ही हैड नेवर सीन सच बियर्ड्स दाढ़ी साइड बर्न्स एंड फैंसी लाइफ में कभी देखी थी। अ वुमन वॉकड इन थ्रू द ट्रेन गेट। शी वॉर अ ड्रेस ऑफ लेग मटन स्लीव एंड स्कर्ट टू द टॉप ऑफ हाई बटन शूज। ओके बैक ऑफ हर on the tracks I caught a glimpse of locomotive a very small courier and Eve's locomotive with a funnel shaped stake and then I okay clear। तो उसने फिर क्या देखा कि एक मटन स्लीव्स की स्कर्ट पहन रखी थी एक औरत ने और हाई बटन उसके शूज़ थे ऊपर तक के बूट उसने पहन रखे थे और बैक ऑफ हर उसके पीछे एक ट्रैक बना हुआ था जिसके ऊपर ही कॉट अ ग्लिम्स ऑफ अ लोकोमोटिव एक लोकोमोटिव क्या होता है लोकोमोटिव रेल का इंजन होता है वैसे तो ओके और क्लियर एक व्हील्ड व्हीकल भी होता है कंसिस्टिंग ऑफ अ सेल्फ प्रोपल्ड इंजन जिसको पीछे धक्का मार देते हैं। तो ही सॉ अ लोकोमोटिव इंजन बिहाइंड दैट बिहाइंड हर ओके ऑन द ट्रैक। आई कोट इवन वो भी था किसका एंड इट वॉज अ स्मॉल कुरियर एंड ईव्स कंपनी का लोकोमोटिव था विद अ फिनल शेप्ड स्टैक एक बहुत सारी फिनल शेप स्टैक उस पर ढेर पड़ा हुआ था एंड देन आई न्यू ऑफिस को पता चला। ओके क्लियर स्टूडेंट्स आई वुड एक्सप्लेन दिस चैप्टर अहेड इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो। टिल देन कीप स्टडिंग पढ़ते रहें आप। ओके स्टे एट होम स्टे ब्लेस्ड एंड थैंक्स फॉर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो बेटा। थैंक यू।